All right, here's what we're working on right at the moment. I'm gonna go ahead and put the new springs in the rear chassis of truck 6 here. The brakes are done. The tires are mounted. We're waiting for some answers on the payloader here. I'm a little skeptical of that bushing. I don't think it's as bad as I'm thinking, so I'm waiting for an expert's opinion on that. That might not need to be a line board, and I really don't know what they do as far as line boring. I don't know if they go ahead and they cut this bushing out here and this one up here and then weld new ones in and then re-drill them, or if they bore them out just slightly larger than what they are and then put a bigger bushing in there. I'm not sure. The front end, that has the bearings in it, so that nothing needs to be done there. So we have some parts over on the bench here, and I have the chair to the right hand side. I have that flipped upside down, and I'm just tapping the holes, more or less just cleaning the threads up just so that everything goes together smoothly. I don't want to cross a thread or something, you know, have rust get in there. Everything came apart relatively easy. However, we're just running a tap down in the holes just to clean the threads up. So that there's the chair, the spring set on that. This is upside down and the spring set on there, and then they get bolted in. There is the top plate right there. There is holes that 3/4 inch holes on the back side that you put an adjuster bolt in to get your spring pack squared up so your axle's not walking sideways. I've got those already tapped. I've got 3 more holes to do on that chair. So we're gonna go ahead and get this back together. We're waiting for a flywheel, and once the flywheel is here, they will be able to start putting the transmission back in it. But for right now, and get the springs in. Alright, so all we're basically doing here is just running this tap down into the hole. Now this is a 7/8 fine thread, and this here is the 3/4 inch coarse thread that I ran in the top plate. And all it is just got, it's got 4 sides to it. They're real sharp, and it's just cleaning the threads up. Now, I know a lot of you that are watching these videos are kind of doing this kind of work, and you already know what this stuff is, you know, you already kind of basically know what we're doing here as we're doing it. But there is some people that haven't seen this kind of thing getting done before, and I don't like talking down to any of you that already know what I'm doing. I don't need to be explaining, you know, how a wheel works or anything like that, but I'm just basically describing this little task here as we move along, just to kind of show the people that don't really know or have done anything like this before. So I'm just cleaning these threads out so that the bolts will go in nice and easy. Once we get the threads cleaned out, we'll blow all of the filings out of the holes. There's some rust that's down in there. These are dead end holes too, so we want to make sure we clean everything out, because whatever's in the hole and we go to put the bolt in, it's going to be in there for the lifetime of these springs. We'll go ahead and put some anti-seize on everything just so that it kind of comes apart a little easier next time. It came apart real good this time, so whenever these springs were done last, they must have used anti-seize on it. That pin came out of the front eye of the spring real easy. These all spun out of here. I did have to heat up the adjuster bolt that goes in the top plate, but that gets a lot of crap just setting on the top of them springs. So I was glad that we didn't break them bolts off or anything, and that is one of the main reasons why we're cleaning these threads up, just because of how hard those bolts came out. So I've got one more hole to clean up here, and then we'll come back at you once we get setting the springs into place here. Set this spring pack in real quick here, and then we're gonna go back to working on the payloader. I got a hold of a friend of mine, Jay Oswald, who works on this stuff. I sent him a little video on how much play there was in that bottom hole, and he said that is absolutely not anything to worry about. So we're gonna go ahead and get this back together. We had to feed with the 544 this morning. So we should be able to get everything all rolled into place, and hopefully by the end of the day here, this thing's back going again. All right, we have started the reassembly process here, and we're pressing in this lower bearing, and we're using the bottle jack. So go ahead and give her some juice there, Jay. Yeah, hold on a minute.
You want to try to square this up? Stick it more center.
Let me go like this. Okay, we go a little more. Alright.
Very little.
Alright, let off some. Yeah, wait a minute. That's going. So we've got the bottom one together, got the top one going in. Now what Jay is doing is he is welding around the inside of that lower bushing, and by welding around that, once you get the bead all the way around on the inside, once that cools down, it will contract, and when it contracts, that bushing that's in there is actually going to shrink, and we'll be able to pound it out and pound this new one back in. So this is the top plate here that's going to go on top of the bearing that's inside that top link, which is right here. So we've got a bunch of these parts, and we're just about to the end of what parts we have here. So once that cools, we'll be able to pound that out. And right now I'm going to get the top put together, and by the time I get that put together, the bottom should be cooled down. All right, Jason is got that all welded in, and that would probably pound out right now, but we're gonna let that cool a little bit more. Actually, he's ready to get her now. Now we've got the bearing put in the bottom. Now we're getting ready to put the bearing in the top. Now the bearing from the bottom goes in from the bottom, and then the bearing that goes in the top here goes in from the top. So this is what the bearing looks like. It's a double tapered bearing. So we got the race that just popped off of there, and then there's a spacer between them. And then that, of course, get the grease rag pulled out of it. That of course goes in like that. We'll just tap that down into place, and then there's a shim pack that goes on top of there with a grease zerk in it, and that's how you get grease into this bearing assembly. So we'll go ahead and get this put in there, and then we'll pound that race out. We're gonna be able to go back together. You looking forward to going back together?
In no time.
Yeah, that's gonna be a real treat. So
lining
it up is gonna be a treat. So, well, we'll get this in there, and then we'll start pushing it back together after we get that bushing out. You can go ahead and pound that out. That might go right now, Jay. Come right out like butter.
Yep.
Now, I tried.
And that is the top, what we talked about.
Okay, that lip is the top.
Yep.
So, a lot of what we were seeing for wear, that bushing right there, actually we'll show you the new one. So this is the new bushing here, and we'll toss this one up on its side. And here is the new one. Now the new one has got a little bit more to it than the old one. And then this bushing here is gonna come up against the other bushing that's sitting in the bottom there. And then that's where we're seeing some of our hop. So we'll go ahead and get that jammed down into there, and we'll be ready to put it back together there. Got that top bearing in. He's just bolting the plate down now, and then we've pounded that new bushing in the bottom, and we are ready to push this back together. We don't need to do anything else here. Everything should be ready to go now. Tim is gone to Five Star to get this top pin here. And then what you see me use to pound that new bushing into place was the old pin from the bottom. So that's going to work good as a bearing placer, a hammer. You know, that's nice. It's a nice setup. It's the top of that pin is threaded because the bolt comes up through from the bottom. Now we're going to wheel it in. Wheel everything in together. We've got to get these two links parallel with each other. We've got them both up in the air at the top. So gonna have to let the front down, and then what we might have to do is let some air out of these front tires just so that we can get those parallel. Right now they're both lifted up in the air. Well, we are 7/8 pinned. We're not half pinned, and we're not full pinned, but we're 7/8 pinned. We're a little more than 3/4. We got the bottom pin in, and we've got the top one lined up. We're just waiting for Tim to get here with that new pin, and then we can finish getting that one in there. It looks like it's right there. So this was quite a job to get lined back up, but once we put our heads together, it kind of all fell right into place. Now we had it shored up in the back with blocks, and we had it balancing back there so that it wouldn't tip over backwards. We've got a bottle jack under that. However, it wanted to tilt because this is on a tilting axle in the back. So we jacked it up, put a couple of torpedo levels on there, and we got this mainframe on the back of the machine level. We got that level, and then we started leveling up the front. However, we could not get it level because it was too high. So we ended up letting some air out of the tires, and we were just going back and forth with the forklift and the chain falls to get everything to go into place. And I wish I had a camera on this bottom pin, because the last time Jason hit that, it fell in. Just perfect, went perfect. So we're gonna start hooking the hoses up. Tim will be back here in a while. He went on a parts run to pick up a bunch of stuff. We've got the gantry, we've got a chain on each side. Independent, they're independent of each other. It's the same chain. And we've got the forklift lifting up the front of the machine. Now, we did let air out of the tires. However, you can see that they're off the ground now. That enabled us to get it lined up. And then once we got that lined up, we had to lift it a little bit to get that top one to fall into place. So if Tim was here by now, we could have put that in. So we're going to start hooking all the hoses up here. We got a main wire harness that goes up front that does the self-leveling and all that crap. We're going to just go ahead and just start hooking hoses up here, and we'll have it back together. It's probably going to be 2 hours, so we'll join back up with you once we get that other pin in and half the hoses hooked up. And hopefully, in a couple of short hours, we're back together. All right, we are just getting done with this here. We're airing up the front tires. This machine has 19,596 hours on it. And the center pins, the bearings, and the bushings and hardware and whatever, that cost $2,300. We had this done to the 544. We had a equipment rental place do it back in 2013, I believe it was. They replaced the pins and bushings on that, and they also replaced all of the pins and bushings on the linkage that has to do with the front carrier here. That was $8,700. So this job alone minus labor was $2,300. So we're hoping this took care of the problem. It wasn't doing it all the time, but it was clunking and banging every once in a while. And we're gonna roll it out the door here now. We're gonna put the bucket on it, and it will get it back into feeding cows here tomorrow. It missed one day. Now we went and oiled the floor again here while we put this machine back together. We ended up getting a little bit of an oil slick on the floor, and we took it apart, and we cleaned everything up, and then we had some oil lines leaking as we were putting it all back together. But there is about a dozen hoses on here that we had to unhook so that we could split this machine apart. And we had more trouble getting it apart than we had putting it back together. So we were pleasantly surprised with how easy it went back together, because we were anticipating on it being a real mongrel. So let's go ahead and get the bucket on it,
We'll do some digging out of the bunk and see if see how it responds, and hopefully we don't get any clunking and banging to it. But that rear bearing, it had grease in it, but it was all full of rust and everything. And I'm hoping that all the play came from there. I think we caught this early enough to have got ourselves away from any problems. Now, I was a little skeptical of that bottom pin bore hole, but when I talked to Jay from Kleiss Equipment, I actually sent him a little video on that, and he said, it's nothing to worry about, just run it. So in the last video, I was talking about having to line bore that, and I really don't know what they do when they line bore it. I don't know if they cut that all out with a torch, weld the new bushings in there, and then ream them, or if they ream what you have and have you run oversized pins and bushings. So we're gonna get back on this project here tomorrow, and we'll see how this responds to the work we did to it. These guys are cleaning up the mess. They want me to stop talking on the camera, and they want me to get out the door here. Get this lined up on camera here, it'd be a miracle. All right, we're going to neutralize the hydraulics so that we can hook up the hydraulics that go to the rollout bucket. Now, in order to do that, you key the unit here, you hold the hydraulic button, and then you roll the You move the lever back and forth. That's how you neutralize the hydraulics that go to that bucket. And I don't think you've seen me do that correctly. So hold the hydraulic button and then you run that lever back and forth a couple times. So let's go ahead and hook up the hydraulics and run up to the bunk and do some digging. See how it does. All right, we're gonna test things out here. Now this is where we get our clunk. We'd be digging, we'd be making a pass, pushing into a pile. We'd go to lift up right here. And as soon as you stopped to lift up, you'd hear that clunking noise. So I just did it there. I'm gonna try it now. Everything is tight. All right, as you can see, this is back in service. I was a little skeptical, to be honest with you, whether or not this was going to take care of the problem that we were having with that clunking noise. Now, the bearings and the pins and whatever weren't as bad as I thought they would be. However, that's why I was skeptical with it. That hole, I was, the center pin hole there, I was really worried that that was wore to the point where we were going to have to have somebody come in and center bore that and whatever, but that just wasn't the case. So what we had found out with this is we actually caught this early. Had we ignored what was going on and just let it do what it was doing, it would have ended up deteriorating the mainframe of the loader, and then we would have had to have had that addressed. You know, whether they, I don't really know what they do. If they cut that bushing out and then weld the new one in, that is, you know, needs to be drilled back out again to make it true with the top. I don't know what they do there, but I did get a hold of the dealer that sells John Deere construction equipment in our area, and that is Five Star. They have several dealerships all around New York State here, and they had two machines ahead of this one that they were working on, and one more coming in. So they actually had three machines, and a couple of them had to get center board or line board, and it was going to look like, well, they told me that it was going to be 2 weeks before they would have been able to get our machine in. Now, this work is not cheap to have the dealer do it, but it's not cheap to have yourself do it either. So we don't want to rag on the dealerships at all, because they are offering great services. However, we only missed one day of feed with this, and some of this work that we do ourselves is not only it's not really a thing where we're saving any money, it's just we're saving time, and time is more important than money when it gets right down to it. You can change things around in your organization, if you will, or your business to make money here and there, but the one thing that we cannot make is time. And we do have another loader. We used the 544 while we were working on this, but if that had went down while we were working on this, then maybe we would have been a little late feeding cows for a couple of days, and that's going to cost us a lot of money. That'll cost more in labor than what it would have taken to have taken this machine somewhere and had it worked on. So that is going to do it, folks, for this video. I want to thank you for watching. The boys are just getting done spreading manure here now, and we are going to call it a night here. We're going to have to work on the axles on that truck tomorrow, getting them springs back in there, and we'll be coming back at you next with the final work on truck 6. So thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you.